See, whatever I teach, I will record the video and I will be giving the video of the class also to you. Everything from end to end, whatever we are going to teach here. Even see, if you are from non-IT background, if you are from biochemistry, mechanical background also, no need to worry. I will be teaching some basics of Java even. But the only prerequisite to learn the Selenium is you should have a little bit basic knowledge on manual testing. If you don't know manual testing, just ask me personally so that I can guide you manual testing also. But before learning this, you should have a basic knowledge on manual testing so that you can convert. What you will be gaining, what I will be guiding here is I will be guiding completely on real-time scenarios only. There will not be anything like Selenium IDE which got outdated before 2008. See, if you go through syllabus of some institutes or somewhere here, right? You will be having Selenium IDE for first 10 days like that. We will not be teaching those things. And I'll tell you what is the drawback of that. Directly we'll be jumping to Selenium WebDriver. What is there in the present market, what present market is looking for, and including the interview preparations, whatever you need to crack for the whatever it is required to crack the interview, everything I will be giving you. At the end of this course, what we will be doing is I will be giving some set of 45 interview questions for you. Only from those you will be getting in the interview, I can assure you, because I have collected those questions from thousands of students, those who have attended the interview. Once we are into the batch, I mean second week or third week, I will add all your guys into your WhatsApp group where I will be regularly posting the openings also as well. Okay, it's like a community where we will be solving all our doubts and everything. That is a great advantage what we will be seeing here. And apart from the interview questions, after finishing the course, at the end of the course, I will be making you to work on one real-time project as well. At that time, few others also will be joining here, including you. Some others also will be joining real-time project. That is very, very important. And after finishing each and every 1 hour or 1.5 hour, once I leave the break, I will be giving some homeworks to you. You want to do those homeworks and you want to send it to me. If you do those homeworks, you can just Google out for Pratap Selenium. You will come to know about what my students said about me and everything. All the things what they will be telling is practice well, or else you cannot do anything. You can just Google out for Pratap Selenium. You will come to know a lot about me. Actually, this is not my institute. I have my own institute in Marathahalli, Bangalore, Care and Informatics. This is my own institute. You can just go through and connect to my previous students as well and check how good the classes are and all those things. Okay, this is my institute where I used to teach. Since it is a weekend, I have a little bit leisure time. I came here to take the classes here. During morning times, I will be taking the classes here only. What you have to do is you have to do a regular practice. After these every day, after every 1.5 hour, I will be stopping the recording and I will upload this recording session also, and I will give the YouTube link to you, so that you can go through that YouTube and you can revise it back once you go home. If you have any small doubts, you no need to call me each and every time and solve the doubts. You can go through the video itself there, so that you can solve the doubt. That's really great advantage for everyone. And that kind of facility you will not get anywhere also. No one will give you the video. They will get the class or else they will solve the doubts. No one will give you the video. But since I am getting a lot of times to go solve the, since I am spending a lot of time to solve the doubts, I am recording the video and I am giving it to you. You can utilize a lot also. And if you keep on doing the homeworks, at the end of the course, I will be making you to work on one real-time project as well. If you do practice well, then only you can understand that real-time project, or else you cannot understand that real-time project. Initially itself, I am telling you, because I face this issue with a lot of students at the end. You should have a regular practice on these things. Whatever you learn on weekends, try to practice on weekdays and send it to me. If you have any doubts, I will give my number, email ID and Skype ID. You can connect to me and you can solve your doubts. All those things I will be giving to you. Okay, I think from afternoon onwards, you will be seeing my previous batch students also. You can check with them how they have learned, why they are coming here even after learning. They have not practiced sufficient. That is why they are coming here again to solve their doubts, all those things. You don't do that mistake. Even if I tell more than 50% of the students does that mistake, don't do that. At least try to avoid max. Okay. And these are the facilities. Framework, I will be covering four kinds of frameworks here. Data-driven framework, TestNG, which is inbuilt framework, hybrid framework, as well as Cucumber also I will be guiding you here. These four things. Cucumber is a major trending now. Very trending now, and you guys are, see, what I will be doing is I will totally convert you to an experience. No more you will be fresher once you complete my batch. That is the level of expertise what I will be giving here. You, if you want to do that, for sure you have to put your effort. Whatever I teach, 100% if even if I give, when I calculate to the calculate right, it will be around 30% only. The remaining 70% falls in your practice. You no need to practice anything apart from what I teach. That is more than sufficient. But you have to practice each and every point whatever I tell here, or else you will. You, it is too difficult. And during the class, I will give regular notes to you. Take down the notes. That is very important. Even after half of the class, if I stop notes, you yourself will ask, please give the notes, please give the notes. That happens. I will not stop for sure. I will give the regular notes, take down the notes, everything. And everything will be practical only here, except first 2 hours, first 1 hour what you are going to learn. Maximum 1 hour theory what you will be learning here. Apart from that, there will not be any theory at all. Just 5% theory, 90% practicals what you will be learning here. There is nothing to learn theory in Selenium automation. Okay, regularly I will be writing the programs. You want to practice those programs in your home and you want to send it to me. If you have any doubts, you can connect to me at any time. Okay. Any other doubts what you have, what you want to get clarified? Course content I will give you tomorrow or some other time. I will give you day one what, I mean first hour what you are going to learn, second hour what you are, hour to hour I will be giving complete syllabus. I have this already with me. Once everyone joins, I will give you, not an issue. No, included in the, after 32 hours to 33 hours, last 7 hours will be completely on real-time project what I will begin. This is the course content what you will be seeing. At last, these classes you will be learning the real-time project. Here. This is the core overview course content. Whatever you have got is just, each and every topic has subtopics again inside this. Just I am giving you overview content, hour to hour what you are going to learn. This you can take it down tomorrow, not a problem. Okay. Java, see, first what I will be doing, I will be taking first 5 hours of Java and I will be jumping into Selenium. In between, when you are learning Selenium also, you will be learning Java again. Because what happens if you teach specifically Java and if you go for Selenium, right, there will, again when you go for interview, they will ask the coordination between both. Again, you will fail to answer that. That is what everyone are doing, that mistake. Whoever learns by themselves, they do that. They learn well, but what happens, the coordination misses. But when you go to the interview, they ask that coordination only there. That is why first 5 hours, let us learn this Java. Then we can go to Selenium in between. But before learning Java also, you have to learn some other prerequisites are there to learn Selenium WebDriver. First, we will be learning that. Then we will be going to Java. Then we will be going to Selenium WebDriver. First might be today, tomorrow, and next Saturday also, we will be learning the prerequisites. Might be next Sunday, we will be starting with Java topics. The third weekend, we will be starting with Selenium WebDriver. From there onwards, it will take again 4 more weeks to complete our Selenium. Selenium WebDriver, it's a vast one. Day to day, there will be updates. I will let you know at the last class, I will let you know where to get the daily updates and how to work with the updated things, all those things also. Okay. Any other doubts what you have? Saujanya, are you there? Weekend? 40 hours. In a day, 4 hours. In between, there will be breaks for sure. 10 to 2. Because after 1 hour, they will be ready, waiting for break, when he is going to leave, when he is going to leave, that happens. I know that, I know your pain, even I am a student once upon a time. So that I will leave you break in between and we can have. But today, I will take 2.5 hours like that, today and tomorrow. So next week, today is the starting, this is the first day. That's why what I will be taking today and tomorrow, I will take 2.5 hours, 3 hours like that. Next weekend onwards, we can, because at a time, if you start for 4 hours, right, you will run away. It's too hectic and you will feel like that and you will run away. That's why slowly we can increase our pace. Okay. See, like other institutes, right, there is no demo classes and all in my institute. I mean my classes especially. What I will be taking, first come and listen. You no need to enroll or do anything, any payments or anything, any sort of things here. First listen for 30 to 40% of the course. Then you can decide yourself whatever you are learning is good enough or not. Okay, what happens going to some places, right? First 1 hour of demo will be there. You have to enroll for sure. Those things are not at all encouraged in my batches especially. Okay. Now, here we are here to learn Selenium to Selenium automation tool. Before learning that, first let us see. Sajana, can you mute? Okay, no need. No need to mute your mic. Already, there is some sort of disturbance from you. Why we need to learn this automation? What is the purpose of learning this automation?
Saves time.
Okay, before learning automation, first let us see what is meant by testing, first of all. Then we can come for automation. What is meant by testing? Why we need to test an application? Why can't we release the product directly? I hope you are enough experienced with the manual, right, everyone? You guys are more experienced than me. I have only 7 years of experience. And that too, manual, it's just 2 years I have. You guys are more experienced than me in manual. You can write better manual test cases than me. I hope so. Okay, what is meant by testing? Why we need to do testing? You are telling something.
To ensure the quality.
How? How will you ensure the quality? Product passes all the tests. Okay. How will you check again? How will you check the test cases?
We have to create some cases.
According to the specifications or requirements. How will you do that? There is a expected, there is a actual. Compare both. That's it. Nothing you will be doing apart from that. You have an actual, you have an expected. You will compare both. If both are same, you will mark it as pass or else fail. There is nothing to do apart from that in manual testing. The same thing. See, for example, I am working for a product called Gmail or Facebook. Imagine that I am working for Gmail. There are different modules inside that, like inbox module, send module, drafts module, lot of other modules are there. Under each and every module, there will be different test cases again. Okay, on an overview, for example, imagine that there are 1,000 test cases to test the Gmail product. 1,000 test cases to test the Gmail product. How many employees required to test the Gmail product? Every day there will be enhancements keep on going on. In that case, they have to test that application every day. On an average, as per industrial standards, an employee can test 30 to 40 test cases per day, not beyond that. In that case, how many employees are required for me to test the Google product? Every day? 30 to 35 or 40 employees are required to test the Gmail product every day. For example, if the product is withstanding for 20 years, I want to hire the 30 employees for 20 years, right? It's too much cost consuming and everything. That's why what they have, what this HP company, HP, in 1998, they have identified a strategy called automation, first of all. First and foremost, they are the inventors of automation, first of all. Earlier, they don't know what is meant by system automation at all. They have invented a tool called QTP in 1998. What they did is they have automated these 1,000 test cases. And they will keep it as a suit. They will write the automation test cases and keep it as a suit. And one employee is enough to run those 1,000 test cases and get the results of 1,000 test cases. And they can remove the remaining 29 to 39 employees. Only one employee is sufficient to test all the 1,000 test cases. Okay, these 40 employees can take almost 6 months of time to write those 1,000 test cases. After that, it will be cost efficient. They can manage it very easily. How to write that automation test cases? That is what we are going to learn here, but not using QTP, by using some other tool called Selenium here. Okay, there are a lot of other tools also available in the market. We can see about the different tools, what are the tools available in the market, and all those things, and we can see what is the best tool among that, and we can select the best tool and work on that. Okay, now. Since we came to know that, and that too, to test those 1,000 test cases, right, it will take one complete day to test the test cases. But if you have automation test case, right, within 1 hour we can complete the 1,000 test cases. We can take 10 machines and run those 1,000 test cases, 100 test cases in each and every machine and 10 machine, and we can finish that in 1 hour and we can get the results itself. Speed is also very fast. Speed, reliability, everything when compared with when we are testing it manually, right? When we are doing a routine job, we tend to do some failures. But when we are doing through automation, right, that doesn't happen. Anyhow, for sure, we have put some conditions there to check that. That condition will execute for sure. But when we are doing that manually, it doesn't happen. Okay, that is why we go for automation. Let us see, we came to know some advantages of automation. We know already enough about automation, why we want to go with automation. There are different tools available in the market. What are the different tools available in the market, what you know? What are the QTP, okay. HPQC is not an automation tool. It's a management tool, test case management tool. LoadRunner is not an automation tool. It's a performance tool. I am asking about automation tools. There are tens of tools available in the market. Test Complete, good. I have worked on Test Complete. Test Complete. Test Complete. Why you are here? Selenium. Selenium is also an automation tool. What happened to this? It is writing very slowly. Okay, what are the other tools? What you know? Rational Robot, good, by IBM. Rational Robot. ALM is not an tool. It's a bug tracking tool. It's not an automation tool. I'm asking about automation tools. Silk Test, yeah, that is also an automation tool. Why nobody is using? Most of them are using Silk Test also. Really expensive, but it is easy to use. Very easy. Even some 10th fail students also can use that Silk Test. No need to have any knowledge at all. If you have, if you know what are the steps, what we need to do, we can just do that by using Silk Test. But it is quite expensive. There is a tool called OATS by Oracle. There is a tool called Oracle. Sonata also has some tools. There are Silk Test. There is a tool called RenoRex. RenoRex. This is also another tool. Just a minute, guys. I'll come back. These are the different tools available in the market. These are the different tools available in the market. WindRunner is not. It's not an automation tool. These are the different tools available in the market. There are some tens of tools available. See, few companies, what they do, they develop their own tools and they won't outsource it to the market also. They use themselves in the companies. There are hundreds of tools like that when we compare. But out of that, we know only two tools, right? Normally, not only you, if you ask any automation engineer also, they will tell only two tools. One is QTP and another one is Selenium. Because those are the highly used tools in the market. The other tools, they won't use much. These are the only tools what most of the companies are using, QTP and Selenium. And QTP is the masters who have invented the automation strategy, first of all. All the other tools are copying the, see, for example, first C came, then C++, then Java, like that. In the same way, first QTP came, then Selenium, like that, all the other tools are evolving into the market now. Okay. Okay, now it's good. We know the two widely used tools are QTP and Selenium. QTP and Selenium. In the year 1998, HP has invented a tool called QTP, and in the year 2000 they have released into the market. They have officially released into the market in the year 2000. And in the year 2004, ThoughtWorks is the company who has invented this Selenium. Do you know where this ThoughtWorks is located? You are located very closely to here only, right? It is located, there is an office in Koramangala as well, head office is in UK. That is where they developed the tool, Selenium tool. No, it's a UK based company. But most of the development happens here only, in India, Koramangala, Bangalore. Develops, and it is a marketing, head office marketing and those things happens there. See, when we take the statistics of around, I'm poor in drawing. When we take the statistics of around 2004 to 2005, right? when we take the statistics of around 2004 to 2005, 70% of the companies are using QTP at that time. 70% of the companies are using QTP at the time. Only 20% of the companies are using Selenium. And 10% of the companies are using other tools. Other tools. In the year 2004 to 2005. But when we take the present statistics, right, 2016 to 2017 is the latest statistics what we have. When we take the current statistics, what happens here in the sense, 70% of the companies are using Selenium and only 20% of the companies are using QTP and 10% of the companies are using other tools. This will be always there. They develop their own tools and they start and keep on starting working with the tool. Why this drastic change has been happened in this span of 10 to 12 years? What is the reason? By seeing this analytics, whatever we saw, there is a tough competition between QTP and Selenium. Am I correct? There is a tough competition between QTP and Selenium. Why this competition is there? What is the reason which tends everyone to migrate from Selenium to QTP? And why if there is a lot of advantages, why still some 20% of the companies are still using QTP? What are those differences between Selenium and QTP? Let us look into that. As of now, if you have gone through that already, you will be knowing only one difference, that is open source and paid. But when you go for interview, right, they will ask, directly they will tell you the answer. What is the difference between Selenium and QTP apart from open source? Now people become very smart, right? That's why they will tell you that answer and they will ask you other differences. There are many other differences also. If you are really working, you will come to know that. Those differences. Those differences we can see now. What are those differences between Selenium and QTP and all those things. If you want, you can take down this. Just a rough work. Everyone are working in manual testing? We can mostly 99% is the you are from data analyst. Okay, you have very good openings in data side itself, right? Big data, Hadoop and all. Okay. Last two to three pages of your notebook, allocate for interview questions and start taking down the interview questions also. Daily I will be giving at least some 5 to 6 interview questions. At the end of the course, that will be some 45 first interview question. What is the difference between Selenium and QTP? What is the difference between Selenium and QTP? Take down that. What is the difference between Selenium and QTP? Now, let us see the difference between Selenium and QTP here. Selenium and QTP. What is the difference between, list out the differences between Selenium and QTP. What is the first difference? It is a open source tool. It is a, don't take down, I will give you time to take down, listen. It is a paid tool. It is a paid tool. What is the difference between open source and paid? Again, they might ask. Don't tell that I can download it for free of cost. Downloading, anyone can download if you are paid to your internet guy. Right? Any software you can download. I can download Windows also. What is the difference between? While you are installing any software, at the last step of installation, if it is asking a product key, you want to purchase that product key and give that. If you want to purchase that 16-digit product key, you want to pay something to the company which is providing that, then you want to use that software. Then you want to use that software. In the same way, QTP, if you want to use QTP right, now the cost has been reduced. It is just 32,000 per year for one system. Earlier it is 1,20,000 for one system for 1 year. Now since Selenium came into the competition, like Jio, what Jio is doing into the market, the same thing, it came into the market now, and not only this tool, most of the tools, they have slashed down the prices. These guys are giving it for free of cost. Others, of course, they have to slash down their prices. That is how it has happened here. Okay, now if you want to get this QTP license for 1 year, right, you want to pay 32,000. That too, a full professional license you will be getting. Whereas for the Selenium, right, while you are installing, it won't ask you any product key at all, first of all. We'll see that installation and all those things here now. Okay, next. Any other difference what you know? QTP also you can see. But when you compare with QTP, right, even though if it is open source, you will have more blocks than compared with QTP. You will get a lot of support. And installation, see, support in the sense, what that QTP guys gives the support in the sense, only installation and uninstallation. Apart from that, they won't give you any support. If you have worked in QTP, you will be coming to know about that. They will give the, if your machine has some problem, they will solve that and they will go. Apart from, Selenium, you will not get that issue at all, first of all. Any other differences? The Selenium supports, QTP also we can form. There is a way to form. It supports all the operating systems. Selenium supports all the operating systems. It supports only Windows. It doesn't support Mac machines. When you come to the US majority market, right, most of them, they use Mac machines. You guys know that, I guess. Right. In that case, US countries, this tool won't work out. QTP doesn't work out. I buy it for free of cost, still I have advantage. When we come to the point of browsers, right, this supports all the major browsers. Major browsers. If your application is opening only in Chrome browser, right, this QTP doesn't support. It supports only IE browser. It supports only IE. Don't take down, I will give you, listen, I will give you time to take down. It supports only IE browser. It doesn't support any other browser. For example, earlier IRCTC used to open only in a specified browser, Netscape Navigator. In that case, if you want to test such kind of applications, you cannot use QTP, right? That is one more drawback. Any other difference? If you know Java, you can start writing the Selenium code. If you know Python, you can start writing the Selenium code. If you know Ruby, multi-languages, it supports multi-languages. Just a minute, guys. I've ordered for a laptop. It supports all the major browsers. It supports only IE browser. Any other, as I said, the Selenium supports multiple languages, Java, Python, Ruby, C Sharp, Perl, all these languages it supports. Where else this QTP supports only? VB scripting. It doesn't support. If you want to work with QTP, right, for sure, if you don't know VB scripting, you want to learn VB scripting, then only you can do. But see, most of the universities doesn't, when you're during college days, you would have not learned VB scripting. But for sure, you would have learned C Sharp, Python or Java, anyone. That is one more advantage again, right? It supports Java, Python, Ruby, C Sharp, all these languages. Whereas this supports only VB scripting. Any other difference? The size of the software is just 28 MB, whereas the size of the software is 1.5 GB. Size of this QTP. If you want to load that into your RAM, right, at least you should have minimum 2 GB of RAM. Old machines doesn't support, which came before 2000, 1998. They have only 512 MB of RAM. Whereas if you want to work with Selenium, right, if you have old Pentium 1 machines, which is invented in 1990, with 256 MB of RAM, it will be there. Hard disk will be hardly 2 GB like that. With that also, you can install Eclipse in that. You can work with Java. If Java works, of course, Selenium also will work. It is much compatible when compared with QTP. This is one more advantage here. Now, Saujanya, are you there? Are you able to hear me clearly? Yes. Okay. Next. Okay, let us hold this difference between Selenium and QTP. I am going to guide you on general topic. I will come back to this and I will let you know why I have passed this also. Let us resume back this later, difference between Selenium and QTP. I am going to guide you on general topic here. That is very important to learn any automation tool, not only this Selenium. Now, I have a website. I have a website like this. I have a website and this website is abc.com, and I have username text box, I have password box, I have login button, I want to verify the login scenario is working fine or not. How will you verify that? Whether login scenario is working fine or not in this abc.com? By hitting, okay, by entering the credentials. Where will you enter the credentials first of all? Sorry. On the blocks, but if you want to enter there, you need that application, right? Where will you get the application first? First, you need to enter the URL. Before entering, where will you enter the URL? You need to open the browser first. First, open the browser, then open the URL abc.com. Then, what is the next step? What you will be doing? Enter the username. In the username text box, enter the password in the password text box, then click on login button. These are the steps what you will be doing. As a first step, what you will be doing, you will be, after opening the browser and URL, you will be entering the username in the username text box. When you want to enter the username in the username text box, first you will identify this username text box. Then you will perform some typing operation there. Then you will identify this password box. Then perform some typing operation. To do any automation activity, you will be following only two steps. One is identifying the element, and second is performing action on it. These are the only two steps what you will be doing to do any automation activity. See, if you want to click on this login button, first you will identify that element, then perform action on it. That is click operation. For example, if you have a text box here, remember your password text box. If you want to click on the text box, what will you do? First you will identify this element, find the element. Something happened to my system. Okay. First you will identify that element, then you will perform action. If you have a radio button, if you want to click on the radio button, first you will identify that element, then perform action on that element. Am I correct? That is what you will be doing. If you have a link, forget your password link. If you want to click on that link, first identify that element and perform. Not only in Selenium, in any automation tool, if you are doing any automation activity using any tool, you will be doing only two steps. For the next 40 hours of our course also, you are going to do these two steps only. First 5 or 6 hours, you will learn how to identify the element. Next 30 hours, you will learn how to perform action on the different elements. If you learn that, of course, your automation is done. Okay, now, to identify the elements, we will use something called element locators. To identify the element. In Selenium, you have 8 element locators. What is the purpose of element locators?
It will identify
the path of the object. Not path. It will identify the element. To identify the element, we will use this element locators. Very, very, very important interview question. How many element locators are there and what are they? You can go and ask already who is working on Selenium also. They will tell 4 element locators, 5 element locators only. Because we also will be using only 4 and 5 element locators only. But in general, there are 8 element locators in Selenium. We will not be using that in real time also. Since they are not using that, they will tell that there are only 4 or 5 element locators. But since you are learning completely, you have to give a perfect answer telling that there are 8 element locators. What are those 8 element locators? ID, name, link text. I'll let you know in detail what are these things. Link text, XPath. Don't follow that whatever you know. Follow the order what I am telling, because this order is given by experts' advice. If you follow this order, identifying the elements becomes very easy for you. You'll learn that from tomorrow onwards, you will be start learning how to identify the elements. At that time, you want to follow this order also. ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, partial link text. If you want this rough work, you can take down. Next, we can resume back to this. Difference between Selenium and QTP. We have hold that and we have came here. We'll be there up to 12:30. Okay. Up to 12:30 it will be. Tomorrow also. But it is important. If you are continuing for sure you should.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Because I'm not sure about this class.
Okay, fine.
పర్లేదు
ఎట్లా 1.5 hours కదా వినేసి వెళ్ళిపోండి మళ్ళీ మిస్ అవుతారు క్లాసెస్ కొద్ది అర్థమయ్యే ప్రాబ్లం అవుతుంది నెక్స్ట్ బ్యాచ్ ఇట్ విల్ బి మోర్ దెన్ 1.5 months టు స్టార్ట్ ఎ న్యూ బ్యాచ్ 1.5 months. ఓకే ఓకే డ్యూష్ బ్యాంక్ అవి ఎప్పుడు ఉంటాయి. In that case, you have to learn. Yeah. యా ష్యూర్ పంపిస్తాం సౌజన్య, మేము మీ అడ్రస్ చెప్పారంటే పంపించేస్తాం. బిల్స్ అండ్ సర్టిఫికేట్స్ విల్ బి గివన్ ఫర్ ష్యూర్. ష్యూర్ 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 వీ విల్ ప్రొవైడ్, 100% వీ విల్ ప్రొవైడ్. ఎస్ 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 ఇట్ విల్ బి హెల్ప్ఫుల్. ఈ జస్ట్ నార్మల్ నార్మల్ సర్టిఫికేషన్స్ అంతే, ఐఎస్ఓ అలాంటివి అంతా ఏం లేవన్నమాట మాకు. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ ఫర్ ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫైడ్ ఆల్సో వీ విల్ బి గివింగ్ విత్ అదర్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్స్ నేమ్. ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ వన్ ఆఫ్ మై ఫ్రెండ్ హ్యాస్ ద ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ వీ విల్ బి గివింగ్ విత్ దాట్ నేమ్ ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్, నాట్ ఎ ప్రాబ్లమ్. యా ష్యూర్ దట్ వీ కెన్ డిస్కస్ ఆఫ్లైన్. యా ఓకే ఓకే. నౌ వెన్ వీ కేమ్ టు ద పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ ఆటోమేషన్ వీ అండర్స్టూడ్ దట్ దెర్ ఆర్ టూ నెసరీ థింగ్స్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు డూ ఆటోమేషన్. వాట్ ఆర్ దోస్ టూ థింగ్స్? ఐడెంటిఫై ద ఎలిమెంట్ అండ్ పర్ఫార్మ్ యాక్షన్ ఆన్ దట్ ఎలిమెంట్. వైల్ యూ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిఫైయింగ్ ద ఎలిమెంట్ వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఎలిమెంట్ లొకేటర్స్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ద ఎలిమెంట్. ఇన్ సెలీనియం హౌ మెనీ ఎలిమెంట్ లొకేటర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్? 8 ఎలిమెంట్ లొకేటర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. 8 ఎలిమెంట్ లొకేటర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. వెరల్స్ in qtp where there is only one element locator, if that one element locator fails to identify that element, right, we cannot automate that scenario. Again drawback, I buy it for free of cost and everything is good. You buy Jio SIM for free of cost and you have lot of advantage. Only problem is network is not there. Okay, but nowadays they are improving the network also. In the same way they also have implemented free and even network is also proper here. That's why everyone started using this. There is no drawback. At least if you are using the Jio SIMs, there is some drawback. Here we don't have the drawback also. There is one small drawback. We can learn about that also now. Okay, since we are into Selenium, we will be discussing on Selenium. But if you go for QTP, right, they have a lot of advantages. But we know the fact what it happens. That's why no one can't convince us. But the same thing we can do it for the customers as well when we are into the companies. This is why we are not going for the QTP. Why can't we use Selenium and do all those things? And as we discussed in the analytics, statistics, whatever we have saw, still some 20% of the companies are using QTP, right? Why? What is the reason why they are using QTP yet? Okay, fine, good. That's a correct answer. See, Selenium supports only web applications, whereas QTP supports both desktop and web applications. QTP supports both desktop and web applications. What is web applications and what is desktop applications? Can you give some examples for web applications? Give me website name, not any. Give me website names. I need. That is why I'm asking. Google, Facebook, no, anything that, this, it, that and all. I want complete. Not only now, in future also I'll be. Give that, when I click on that, this will appear. Don't give those kind of answers in interview also even. When I click on that button, this button will appear so that I will get that, so that this. What you will understand from that? Apart from that and this, there will not be anything in the answer. You have to clearly tell, when I click on the checkbox, I will get a text. Something when you are explaining, you want to give, you have inside your mind, you think that they are understanding, but they will not get it. Finally, you will find it in the interviews also. These are small tricks in the interviews, what you have to do. When you know something right, very clearly, you have to consume lot of time in the interview to explain them very clearly, so that you will be having half an hour of time to go take the interview. You would have spent almost 15 minutes for that itself. When they calculate the overall percentage, of course, you will qualify in the interview. Okay, now what is web application? What are web applications like Google, Facebook, Amazon, Flipkart, Jabong, Jungly? All these things are web applications. What are desktop applications? WordPad, Notepad, calculator, all these things are desktop applications. Anything which opens in a browser, is a web application. Other applications are desktop application. Even browser itself is a desktop application. Right, are you getting this? What is the difference between desktop application and web application? This Selenium supports only web applications. This is one of the drawback of Selenium. But what happened now in the sense? The Selenium guys are introducing a new tool called Vinium. They are introducing a new tool called Vinium. official version has not been released. I am telling this from past 20 batches, almost 8 months. They are not releasing it. Okay, I don't know when they are going to release. I cannot guarantee you because that is with the ThoughtWorks. Okay, what is the purpose of this Vinium tool in the sense it is used to automate Windows-based applications. And that is a open source again. If that comes into the market, right, totally QTP will get vanished. Okay, this tool is coming. If you learn Selenium, learning Vinium is very easy. I have tried with the beta version. Only beta version is there. They have released the beta version, but officially you cannot work with that beta versions. That's why you can learn, but not implement anywhere. It's very easy to implement if you learn Selenium. Vinium is very easy. It's used to automate Windows. This also is a drawback, but not much, because most of the applications nowadays are web applications. They are becoming into cloud nowadays, so that it will open in a browser only. That is one more drawback. One more advantage nowadays. It's a drawback, but not much drawback. The Selenium, there is something called each and every tool. When you learn any tool, first you will start with record and playback. Okay, any tool, whatever you are going to learn in future also, first you will start with record and playback, then you will be starting doing the coding. When you are doing record and playback, right, Selenium does not record properly. Whereas this QTP, it records properly. But there is no advantage, there is no point of using this record and playback. We are going to learn this record and playback in the next coming, in another 1 hour we are going to learn this record and playback. That's all, we will leave then and there itself. I will not tell even to practice you also that topic. I will stress you a lot of things to practice, but not on this record and playback. Because that is of no use, no companies uses that. When you are learning some tool, initial point you have to see, when you are learning a bicycle, first you will have a step wheels to support you to learn something. After you learn, you will remove that and you keep on going in a bicycle, right? In the same way, when you are learning this tool, first you will have you should have some support to learn how that is generated, what happens. First of all, what is automation? You want to learn that, then you can jump into the coding. In that case, this is also not a big drawback. These two are the disadvantages of Selenium when compared with QTP, but not much. Okay, take down these things. We can step into Selenium and start working with Selenium. Morning 8 to 9:30. That is not here in Marathali. I take in Marathali. If you want, you can connect through online.
Online,
it's virtual. Everything same. You are seeing here, right? One girl is attending. Morning times, there will be many of them who will be attending. Morning 8 to 9:30. Okay. You stay here, close. Huh?
Srinagar.
Oh. It comes near Banshankari. I'm not taking weekdays class. Some others are taking. In Marathali. Weekdays. And that too, for weekdays, it's already filled. For 23rd batch. 23rd, I'm going to start a new batch. There are only 22 seats for where I can accommodate, but there are nearly 30 people who is looking for that. All previous references, I cannot tell no to them also. Yeah, sure. Yeah. You can take down my number. You can call, ping me. 95-911-79-691. That's my number. Okay. Okay, then fine. You can ping me in WhatsApp to that number so that I can list it and I can call you. Okay, fine. Thank you. There are many tools. Companies develop their own tools and start working. record and no playback, no company will encourage you to do that. That's of no use. This is the last theory class what you will be learning. No more theory. Okay, done, everyone? Yes. Now let us learn about selenium. What is selenium? Point by point we can learn. What is selenium? Selenium comprises of three components. Selenium comprises of three components. That is selenium IDE, selenium RC and selenium web driver. Selenium grid is not a component of selenium. Okay, so in few documents you will get a selenium grid also, but that's not a component of selenium. That's a separate technology. If you have a selenium code, how to run that in different machines, you will be using selenium grid. Don't tell selenium grid also as a component of selenium. Selenium IDE, RC and web. See, in the year 2004, this is integrated development environment. Integrated development, take down this, development environment. Selenium IDE, RC is nothing but remote control. Control and Selenium web driver. These are the three components of Selenium. These are the three components of Selenium, IDE, RC and web drive. See, initially in the year 2004, they have implemented the Selenium IDE. They have found some lot and lot of drawbacks of the Selenium. Now we can see install the Selenium IDE and look into that. What are the drawbacks of this? Okay, it just takes 5 minutes to install the Selenium IDE. Then in the year 2007, slowly they have implemented Selenium RC by overcoming all the drawbacks of Selenium IDE. Again, they have some drawbacks with the Selenium RC, because when you run something, it is running very slowly with Selenium RC. Then they have implemented a new tool called Selenium WebDriver in the year 2008, 2007 ending and 2008 beginning, they have implemented the Selenium WebDriver. From there onwards, everyone are using Selenium WebDriver only. Nowadays also, all the companies are using Selenium WebDriver. No point of learning Selenium IDE and RC. It's a waste even if you learn. Okay, that's why we'll concentrate fully on Selenium WebDriver. Okay, but if you want to learn Selenium WebDriver, for sure you should have knowledge on Java. Without having knowledge on Java, you cannot learn Selenium WebDriver. We'll be learning those concepts also here. Okay, first let us see about Selenium IDE. Shall we take some 10 minutes of break and come back? Because we will be continuing till 12:45 something. We can have a quick break for 10 minutes and come back, reassemble. Okay, that's fine. Saujanya? Yes, we can have a break for 10 minutes and we can come back.